thrill to be talking about the Electric Ladyland album that Jimi and I did 50 years ago. It's scary, and it's sometimes I scratch my head and wow, was it really 50 years? It's gone in a flash. Restoring that album in another dimension. This is a dimension that Jimi and I had probably stumbled on by accident. We had wandered into this crazy world of four-handed mixing, because there was no computers in those days, and phasing all over the place. And somehow by accident, we stumbled on this wacky sound where all of a sudden, in the left and right image, it jumped behind our heads and we looked at each other, well, how did we do that? I don't know. So let's keep working. Ain't no use in getting uptight. Just let it groove its own. From that moment, the album sort of took really strange turns. I mean, obviously the crazy effects that we were doing as well incorporated, but there was this mysterious aura about Electric Ladyland where sounds would just appear behind you. It was wrong, and I knew it was wrong, but nobody really cared. When something's out of phase, the signals are crossed in the sense that one speaker is pushing and the other one is pulling. Polarity has been changed. And we did this via two or three tape machines trying to get this flanging, crazy effect, which we use quite often on many of the songs. But somehow we managed to stumble into this sort of stationary, out of phase content where the image all of a sudden shifted from the left to right all the way to the back behind our heads. And theoretically, that's totally incorrect. If you try to cut a disc with that on it, the out of phase information would make the stylus jump right out of the groove. So anything that's out of phase in the audio world is considered a big no-no. The move to America was the first step in my realization that the world is your oyster, you can do whatever the hell you want. Jimi, having moved to America prior to my coming to America, and I was invited to come and join him to help finish Electric Ladyland and continue my work with Jimi, that was the big freedom for me. Being in America for me was like an explosion of my brain. I didn't know quite how to handle it in the beginning, but it was wonderful. Electric Ladyland presented itself to us as the perfect vehicle to make 5-1 out of. On the original, we're panning from left to right. Lots of movement, you know. Jimi loved the fact that I could just roll with that and just make the thing move from left to right. But now, we have a complete soundscape. Left, center, right, left, rear, right, rear. The whole circle is involved. I can make Jimi's guitar start in one corner, pan over the top, go back down, around to the left or right, come behind me, and it makes it so exciting. Every time I was doing something like that, I felt, yeah, you would have liked that thing spinning around like a motorcycle, just zooming around your head. That was the cool part. The challenge was how to make phasing follow in 5-1, and all the delays and all the crazy sounds that we were up to. I go back to my original two-track and I'm listening to the two-track and then the 5-1. Always A-being every 10, 15 seconds just to make sure whatever I've done relates back to those crazy mixes where we didn't know what the hell we were doing. We were flying by the seat of our pants and crazy stuff was going on. I think if Jimi had been there, he would have been right on, just keep cranking on that big panning control.